So far, we've seen Nvidia try to create a mining card, and we've heard all kinds of speculation about AMD doing the same type of thing. But I'm going to tell you right now that mining cards aren't going to be bought by the miners. Let's talk tech. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to the Your CD Key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. When Nvidia released the RTX 3060, at the same time, they released some cards that were geared strictly for people who were doing mining. You know, these cards were geared for people who just wanted to mine, not play games, and that was supposed to be the solution. And then a lot of people started saying, hey, you know, AMD should do the same thing. They should make their cards so that, you know, they can't work with hash rates and so that nobody can do any type of mining on those cards. Well, it was a complete failure all the way around. And there's reasons for this. And the reasons are, you know, I mean, they're probably pretty solid as far as, you know, the mining person is concerned. But for gamers, this seems to be a really big issue because when I made the last video, a lot of people, you know, in the comments were like, hey, you know, AMD and Nvidia should stop these guys from buying these cards. There's got to be a solution. And then other people are saying, hey, there's no way. I don't want this blocked. I want to be able to mine and be able to game. Well, you know, after that, you know, we get the miners themselves who are chipping in. And the main reason that you're not going to see any of these mining cards actually being bought and solving the issue is this. If you take a look at how this entire industry is, okay? And when I'm talking about the industry, I'm talking about the people that are doing any type of mining, whether it's Bitcoin, Ethereum, whatever. There's a bunch of them out there. Blockchain, it doesn't matter. You know, these guys all like to get the cards, use these cards until they're not, you know, worth anything anymore to them, and then turn around and resell them to gamers. Now, in their defense, they say that they always clock the cards to the lowest clock speeds. They keep the cards running cool. So that basically, you know, they're saying the cards, you know, aren't stressed out like a gamer would use the cards. Okay. Now, in some ways that makes sense, but also, it means they're not gonna have any interest whatsoever in buying these other mining cards because they're not going to be able to go out and buy these mining cards, use them, and then when they're no good to them anymore, resell them. I mean, what are they gonna do? I mean, you've got a bunch of these cards you just invested your money in, all these mining cards, and now the entire floor has dropped out on whatever you're doing, so you've got all these cards that are virtually worthless, right? I mean, let's face it, if you can no longer use the cards to do the type of mining that you're doing, then that card becomes irrelevant to you totally. So you're never going to see the people out there who are really into mining wanting to buy strictly mining cards. And the reason, like I said, because of this is because they want to use the card and then pass that used card on to you when they're done. Now, some people might say that's kind of, you know, unethical, you know, or it's, you know, it's a little bit on the shady side. I mean, I don't know if it's really unethical or shady. I mean, as long as people are being honest about what they're doing, that's okay. But you're going to probably see somebody who's taken a card, used it for a really long time, and then turn around and try to sell that card and just say, oh, there's no, you know, no gaming hours on it. But just because there's no gaming hours on that card does not mean that card has not been used for a long time or that that card is going to be, you know, like, you know, a new card at all. You're taking a big risk. Now, the miners themselves, they're not taking a risk whatsoever. What risk is there to them? They're sucking up the cards as soon as they come out. They take these cards, they do what they want to do with them, and with the market being so fracked up the way that it is right now, these guys can pretty much take a new card, use it, make their money, and then turn around and sell that card for, you know, for like almost what, twice or three times the MSRP? Because this is going on eBay. You're even seeing Amazon now selling cards that are way beyond the MSRP, which truthfully, I agree with you guys. I think that a card should not be able to be sold at a certain level over an MSRP. I agree with you guys. I think that should be technically illegal. Back in the day when there were concerts everywhere and people sold, you know, scalped concert tickets, you weren't allowed to charge more than double the face value of the ticket or you get in trouble. I mean, there were obviously people who did it because there are people doing illegal shite everywhere every day. That's just human nature, but still, they weren't supposed to be doing it that way. Now, maybe putting a regulation on cards of the same type of nature where you say, hey, you know what? You can't sell this card for $1,200 because the card only cost you $300. I think that's a good thing. But the whole thing with that is that you're asking these companies now, AMD, Intel's gonna be coming out with their own graphics card. You're gonna ask these companies now to not only make and sell you the card, you're going to be asking them to guarantee pricing on your card. And that's where I think it's going to get hard, because at the end of the day, corporations care about selling stuff. I don't really think that Nvidia or any of those guys really care, you know, that much. I think they'd prefer to have gamers get the cards because gamers talk about the stuff and they're like, hey, this card's great, and they get other gamers. But at the end of the day, if some guy who's mining goes and buys the entire stock of their cards and their cards are sold out, I mean, they've made their money technically. Is it actually really good for them? I don't really see how, because if none of the gamers can get their hands on gaming cards, which is what, you know, Nvidia is technically selling, they're selling gaming cards. it's kind of backfiring, right? I mean, it's just not really working all that well. So there are things that need to change in the industry, but what the solution is, I'm not exactly sure of. I love to hear your guys' opinions. You guys always have great insight at Stuff to Stuff as well. So like always, I invite you guys to make comments and give your insight on what's going on. But as it stands, asking Nvidia or AMD to make strictly cards that are made for mining is going to be a total fail. It's not going to work. It's not going to solve any solutions for the gamers whatsoever. It's just going to create, I would honestly say, probably create even more just confusion in the market. Now, will there be some people out there who buy these mining cards? Sure, they'll buy them up. There'll be people that do it. But the overall effect is not going to be what they want. Miners want to be able to get a card, use it as much as they can until the second it becomes worthless to them. Then they want to turn around and sell that card at an extremely high price on the market, which means they're like doubling and tripling their digits and their, you know, and their money return on a video card that they're buying. So that's just crazy, crazy stuff. Mining cards have proven to be a failure. They're going to continue to be a failure until some other solution comes along that solves all of this. So I'm Elric. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. Like I said, mining cards, they're not going to be bought by miners. They're just not going to. Who will buy them? I don't really know. I'm sure there's a little bit of market. Like I said, I want to hear your guys' comments. I appreciate you guys as my audience, and I'm glad to be back here making videos on YouTube once again. So, peace out. If you'd like to support my channel or subscribe, please hit the subscribe button and hit that notifications bell so you know I'm making videos. If you'd like to support my channel, you can do so either by buying one of those Windows keys. And by the way, all of the codes are guaranteed by the company and me. It's the same company I've been doing business with for years and years and years. They just have multiple sites. You don't have to worry about that. Also, if you want to support the site and don't want to spend a penny, try Amazon Prime for free. I have a link down below. Just click on that link and try it for 30 days. It helps me. It helps you. You can enjoy it. And we both win. And if you have a single dollar, you can support me on Patreon. Sorry for all the sales pitch, folks. Just that, you know, money does run the site. That's the way of the world. So we'll see you guys back here on Tech of Tomorrow for more tech.